Monday morning sick.
Oh,
here's runner.
And we are here. And ladies and gentlemen, we got a very special guest today. So everybody, runner gunner,
give
introducing
it up
to our man, Brandon K. AKA BK.
Hey,
Brandon
K. What is guys? Up? I got my water here, and you're here with the Beatles of podcasting.
Yeah,
Gunner and Brandon yeah. K.
It is an honor to hear that.
It is an honor for you to say that, sir.
And thanks for having me.
And thanks for...
Not a problem.
Technically, you're having a Monday morning sip with us, even though what you're drinking is just water.
This is our first interview of the new season. Not only 2023, but the new season, which is season 6. And we are ready to get this show crack-a-lacking.
Corrected.
Just like...
Crack-a-lacking.
Agrocious. So, we are here to interview Mr. BK, Brandon.
Brandon K.
And before you interview me, I'll just say interview you and say, you guys have been doing this for 6 years?
Six seasons.
Oh, how long is a season?
Well,
three months.
Okay, now that we're clear. Okay, awesome, guys. Hey, you guys are persistent. I love the show. I love the advice that you give to Lenny's.
Yes!
The advice you
Changing
give
Lenny's lives.
To men about their... How they should treat women.
Yes. Right on.
And
right on.
I love all the stuff about entertainment, music. Gunner here sat and listened to every Beatles album and every Elvis album and every Rolling Stones album. And I'm
right on. I'm a big fan of all the old school music as well.
It is
BK,
true.
And we love this stuff. You know, we love doing this, and it's an honor having you here on our show because we. You know, we need more people like him that are non-Lennies, that are ready to change the world, that are ready to change others, to improve others in their lives,
yes.
And make the world a better place to live, and treat females the way they ought to be treated
absolutely.
In the United States of beautiful
females
America.
Right. That's
God
the message.
Shed his grace on thee.
America.
All right, so just to go back to what we were saying, we did go a little extra long in season 5. This is still technically season 5. But only because we're postponing season 6.
We are still... That's why I said
it has accumulated like a pressured up bottle, like a pressured up grolsch.
Can I be episode 1 of season 6?
You want to be in episode 1 of season 6?
1-6? Yes. Yeah.
All right, wherever you are in time, you will be on that episode.
We will include you.
However you guys want to do it.
Whatever way we will, you will be included in that episode.
Yes.
For now, we're still... Just like you said, I said it is season 6, but I was just, you know, hyping up the whole emotion of getting into season 6 because season 6 is going to have so much more. We're looking at, you know, more improvements, just like we've been saying, more of everything.
More.
We're going to do run in the streets. We have so much more improvements coming on inside the show that are going to happen with this Runner Gunner show. So that's what we're
saying.
Right. But this is season 5 still towards the end of it, actually. And we got BK, our man right here, Mr. Brandon K. So let's ask him some
Brandon
questions.
K, let's
get into this.
Let's go down into this. All right, the first question for Mr. Brandon K is, what were you like in 1999?
Yo. you know what
Give us that rewind, sir.
1999 was a great year. You know, it was before I was an adult.
Sure was.
And same with you guys, I assume?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We were all teenagers, whatever.
Oh, yeah.
Not... Anyways,
1999.
N64. I was a freshman in high school.
Wow.
I remember going to a Weird Al concert.
Weird Al Yankovic.
Orange County Fair.
So cool.
That was
so cool.
I'm just thinking about that because last week I brought up Weird Al and Gunner started doing Weird Al lyrics off the top of his head.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, people need to know about Weird Al. These young kids need to know about Weird
they
Al.
They do.
So funny.
They do. He remakes. He's a master of recreating and making it a joke, you know, like.
Yeah.
He is the master of comedy when it comes to lyrics and when it comes to the whole music scene. He is the master of that. He's like number one comedian.
Yeah.
And I agree with you.
He's number one.
BK, I agree with Brandon because he is correct when
He's
it comes
talented.
To this. And so go on, Brandon. 99.
And
we're living in 99.
Just Weird Al being a joyful guy. N64 being a joyful time. the movies being joyful. Just
there were such joyous movies back then, too.
I went to
like Saving Private Ryan.
I personally did
Saving Ryan's Privates.
Summer camp, which was
summer camp in '99.
Yep.
Oh man,
kind of like. From between 8th grade and 9th grade, just like you go to summer camp. You
know? Patty Wars.
Was there rolling blackouts Y2K while you were there?
No, but that's a good point about why we were all worried about Y2K.
Yeah.
The Willennium. The end of the world. I remember Will Smith was popular at the time.
The Willennium?
The Willennium.
The Willennium.
Joy. Yeah. Again, joy. Joyful music.
And during the Millennium,
welcome to Miami.
He had that one and the Jiggy with It.
Oh yeah,
the getting jiggy with it. Nah, nah. Mm-hmm. And plus, he's talking about Men in Black. MIB, probably one came out about that time. Independence Day came out before that. Yeah, yes. 97. You're right.
MIB was 97, but the second one was on the way.
Yeah,
and
1999 was and Independence Day was 96. Stole the show. Stole
Sixth
the scene.
Sense. Mm-hmm. Sixth Maybe Sense. My favorite movie.
Wow,
Sixth Sense.
There it was.
Great.
And Lenny's out there, if Mr. you don't Willis. Know, back to the Weird Al, you know, Harry Potter plays Weird Al in a new movie. It's pretty funny. Weird Al produced it. If you don't know who Weird Al is.
It's a documentary movie, right?
1999. Yeah,
what it
kind
is?
Of. Oh,
the doc movie?
It's a, I think it's a,
it's a real movie.
I think it's a mockumentary. But
a mockumentary.
But it's a, like, autobiographical. Yeah.
Autobiographical. And I haven't watched it yet.
Auto-beautiful.
Autobiographical.
Wait, how many auto booties do you think he got?
So many.
When he did his concert, it would be like auto bootyful because they would roll backstage.
Let's put it this way. He got like way more than Kurt Cobain. And he sang his song. Smells Like Teen Spirit.
And you know what's the trip about Weird Al Yankovic is that he's so weird. But yet, this guy never really drank a beer. I mean, he didn't like to get high or drink. He never got hooked on drugs or anything. He was just naturally a weird, cool guy. But it's true, and it's really cool. Yeah, it's really cool that he never got...
He was Amish.
A lot of rock stars, and he is considered a rock star. Yeah, his dad was Amish, but he was considered a rock star in many, many people's opinions. I don't know about you guys, but I think he was considered a rock star.
Well, back then, I just want to say one more thing about 99. They used to have Al TV, and you would go on VH1 or MTV. MTV was huge at the time.
Oh, I remember that show.
You would sit and watch Weird Al TV or anything on MTV at the time, and it was a much better stuff on there.
You're talking about before the real world took over. You're talking about before all these reality shows, took over the whole MTV genre.
Not to hate on any of the reality shows,
but
it did take over.
I know, I'm saying it's cool, but I'm just saying that this is when videos were actually played on MTV,
VH1,
and... BT.
All the Lennies are the only ones who are like, what's a music video?
Yeah,
we
man. We are blessed to grow up.
We had Real World, Road Rules, and that was all.
That was it. And then, if they had a throwback Beavis and Butthead episode, they'd throw it on there, too. And I even remember them playing Ren and Snippy when Nickelodeon lost the rights to Ren and Snippy and it went to MTV also.
That's a deep cut. But I used to watch it on Nickelodeon, but it probably was on MTV for a second.
So, at one point, they were just strictly music videos. Pretty much. Not strictly.
Interdimensional.
But
interdimensional.
It was
interdimensional
deeper.
And interdimensional.
Interplanetary.
Remember that music video?
Interplanetary.
Mm-hmm.
Like those robot guys and they're destroying the buildings or saving.
Big old Godzilla. Like Godzilla robot.
Yeah.
Yeah. Godzilla robot.
I was going to say, what videos did you guys like from 99 or time? That was, Beastie Boys.
Well, me, I was heavily into a lot of... it was...
Eminem. The Eminem music videos were so funny.
I was into
funny.
Wu-Tang more than anything.
The Wu-Tang music videos.
I was
videos.
Into Wu-Tang a lot.
Yep.
All that Wu stuff was insane. I mean, hip-hop was at its peak pretty much. One of its peaks.
Oh, the scar tissue music?
It had been
music?
At its peaks during those years.
I pulled up a music video list from...
Going back in time now.
From the intranet.
Back in time to 99.
See what
back
BK does to us? He takes us way back to the double nine.
Check
so
this
here
one out, BK.
Go.
What
Thank
about
you, Mr. BK.
Still My Sunshine by Mark Costanzo?
You
can steal my sunshine.
Yeah, that was a funny video.
What about this one? Every morning.
I've thought about that one for a while. Every morning there's... Sugar Ray was definitely mine.
Sugar Ray.
All I had to say was every morning and we could sing it. Scar Tissue.
But what about this one right here?
Smooth?
Smooth by Santana.
Oh, yeah.
The most famous.
That's it? The best guitarist. The best guitarist. Of that year had to be Santana, in my opinion. I mean, come
Absolutely.
On.
Absolutely. That was the biggest song of the year, I remember.
Yeah, that was bad.
Our family, we used to have parties, and way before the Rona, and that was the
You're talking
hit.
10 years before the Rona, man.
20.
What are you talking about? Oh, yeah, 20, you're right.
20 years
That'll
before
be
the Rona.
My bad. He's talking 20 years before Corona.
We used to have awesome parties. The whole family would get together. We'd jump in the pool. The dog would be in the pool. And that song would be blasting.
What I'm thinking? Are they
over, like, not just once.
Is the community going to be dumb? I mean, is the United States going to be dumb and say the Rona anniversary? You know, when it's like 2039 or 2029, I mean, are they going to say, you know, 10-year Rona? Like, just like they do it with the 9/11 stuff. They call it an anniversary. I don't agree with that. I think they should
memorialize it somehow.
They should call it a tragedy. They should call it the so-and-so tragedy. Not an anniversary or a memorial or anything like
memorial
that.
Memorial, maybe, because we don't want to forget, like,
memorial.
How easy we can take it down, you know?
But also a tragedy would make you more aware of the situation. Like, it shouldn't happen
called
again.
The tragedy of
shouldn't happen
right.
more than once. Tragedy should happen once and end it.
So we got another question 99. For Brandon K.
Thank you, BK, for 99 memories.
Brandon K, Woo! We want to know, what is Woo! Your favorite 1950s song?
Oh, man.
Well, you're going way back.
Way back now.
You could go from 50 to 59. Not 49.
Not 49.
50 to 59.
Not
any 63. Song.
I would easily,
not I Want to Hold Your Hand by the Beatles.
I would easily say, yeah, any... I would easily say Beatles all the way, but that was 60s.
That was 60s.
I have 60s. To go even further back.
Even
to
further.
So you're going to the Beatles influences is what you're going to. Well, yeah, pretty much the Beatles influences. So we're talking 50, not 49, 50. Right? Swing, you know, swing was still going on in 1950.
Elvis was there. Will Orbison was there.
Brown? 51.
James Brown was there.
James Brown was a baby, though. He was a young guy.
If James Brown was there.
He was a baby, though.
If James Brown was there, then I would say it's James Brown.
What about Buddy Holly and the Crickets?
Buddy Holly. And what songs
what
did
about...
he sing? See, I was born in 1985, so what did the Buddy Holly sing?
That'll be the day. Words of Love. The original Words of Love?
How does Words of Love go?
It's a Beatles song also. Mm. But, okay. Moving on, I mean, there's a lot, so many. All right, so
it turns out that James Brown was mostly 60s.
Yeah, he's 60s.
Man.
1950s, though, but there's a lot of them. It's okay.
How about you guys? What are your favorite 50s artists?
Mine, go
ahead. Orbison, Elvis, Buddy Holly, Richie Valens, all the Rocky Rollers.
Frank
Bill
Sinatra?
Hammy, he was 40s, but he did his thing.
He did a lot of 50s, yeah. His 50s is popular.
So are you going to say Frank?
Yeah, Frankie.
Frank Sinatra.
Frankie.
I did it my way.
Frankie.
Oh, Frank. My goodness.
So, Gunner. Actually, he asked you a question, and he wanted to know, BK wanted to know, who is your favorite artist from the 50s? So now you got to answer that question, and I have to answer as well. Go!
Elvis Presley.
Elvis. And I'll refer back to Buddy Valens. I mean, Richie Valens.
Both of them?
I mean, Buddy, yeah.
It's a tie?
I don't know.
I can confirm that Runner likes Elvis. He did it at karaoke. He did a spot on Elvis impression.
You mean Gunner?
You gotta do it.
Gunner, yes, Gunner.
Gunner did it. Oh yeah.
Spot on Elvis impression on both, at both the karaoke and possibly on my podcast, which
the
is
problem
coming
is
out.
I can do Elvis too.
At BrandonKingShow.com,
BK,
I am gonna put up an interview with Gunner at some point.
Yeah.
He was singing Beatles songs and Elvis songs.
Oh,
on my
man.
Podcast.
All right, everybody, we got to take a quick commercial break.
All right,
we'll come back. We're going to ask Brandon K a few more questions.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to have to head on down the road. If you want to catch him, catch more of him and what he does and see what he does as an artist and individual, you can go on the Brandon K Show on Instagram.
The Brandon K Show, everybody, represent the Brandon K Show. And we will let you know how cool he is. And we're going to interview Brandon K. So if you want to hear more of him and more of the Brandon Gunner Show and much more, then tune in and stay tuned.
Stay tuned.
We'll be back.
Also, Brandon K might be getting his own podcast pretty soon. I don't know. It's in the talks. So anyone who's listening to this might want to listen to him when it comes down. And we're going to ask Brandon K so much more questions, so much more liveliness, and so much more tacos and shrimp.
So stay tuned because we're going to get back to you guys and kick some more butt.
Oh, that's because we just went to Johnny Shrimp Bowl right now and ate some Johnny Shrimp Bowl.
Shrimpy dimp.
Shrimps and fish.
Shrimp for pimp.
It was great. It's the Brandon K Show on the Runner and Gunner Show. Everybody, we got so much more for you. Stay tuned.
And we'll be back after these commercial breaks.
Who knows where the road will lead us? Only a fool. Nash rules everything around me. Queen, get the money, dollar bill, yo.
I grew up on the crime side, the New York Times side. Staying alive was no job, had second hands. Moms bounced on old men, so then we moved the shit.
Monday morning. Sipperoo Bonsai.
And everybody, we are still here. We are with our super duper guest starts of the new year, the best guest of the new year, who is Brandon K. Mr. BK's in the home.
Brandon K.
That's right. I got my water, sipping on it, and zappy zoo.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, Brandon K., we got a question for you. And we want to know what you think about the Wu-Tang Clan, the group.
The one you were just playing. Yeah, Wu-Tang Clan.
Wu-Tang Clan.
And how monumental were they to popular, the hip-hop industry?
Popular in the 90s.
Old Dirty.
RZA, GZA, Method, Red.
Yep.
Right.
Yeah, they are excellent rappers.
You Got Deck, yeah.
I love those Ghost, guys. I don't Ray. Know enough about them. Somehow, I never sat there and listened to a whole album. I saw RZA live.
Oh, RZA. Oh, okay. There right we go. On. Yep.
Tell us about that.
That is my favorite rapper.
Oh, man.
Alive.
Tell us about that live experience.
Wow. Yeah, let us know.
I don't want to get it wrong in case it
where
was.
Where did you see him
in
at?
In case it was GZA, I don't want to get it wrong.
Yeah, yeah. But they're cousins. Them, they're
but,
actually cousins.
But one of them I saw, two of the guys from Wu-Tang I saw in Vegas.
Right on.
Playing at a big hotel. Playing in front of like a pool, in front of like water, like a big crazy pool.
Yeah.
And just rapping. Heck just a DJ and rapping. And you have to respect somebody who just goes there and raps nothing big and crazy. But I respect those guys and I love Redman. I've listened to Redman albums and Method Man albums. And,
yeah.
Very okay. Cool. Have you played the video games? Have you watched the movies?
Ha-ha. I didn't know they had video games. What's the video game?
I forgot. It's called Wu-Tang
They have
Clan.
One, and actually, the PS1 one is actually the best
Where you fight
one,
each other?
Where you fight each other, and they have all 9 members, and they go at each other, and then they go at, like, these bad guys. Pretty much, they go against Lenny's. So, pretty much, the game is Wu-Tang versus Lenny's. And so, they always whip the Lenny's butts, and in the end, Wu-Tang overcomes the Lenny's.
And then
just like the Renegade Show and our man,
Brandon K.
BK.
And they have the Sega Genesis version, too.
And please, I want you to track that game down because I want to play that game. That sounds awesome.
It's on PS1, and it's called Wu-Tang. It's pretty awesome. It really is awesome. Like
they had their hands
check
in,
it out.
In a lot, it is. Of, in a lot
oh,
of
man.
Games.
They had
T-shirts.
They,
and
they had
like album.
Clothing.
Every
the
single
sign.
One of them probably had an album. Like
the
they
W.
Were, they did. Yeah, they all had, you know, they all
Old
had
Dirty
solo
Master?
Careers.
Yeah.
ODB rest his soul. He's gone now.
He's in it.
He's awesome.
But he
too.
Was he was in that game as well.
Yep.
So I mean, they were all in it. They're all awesome. These guys are pioneers of what the kids now are, what the adults now call hip hop or rap or trap or whatever they call it. Crap.
Well, what do you call rap, Brandon K? What is your favorite rap artist?
My favorite rap artist.
Or artists
of all time. Wait. BK is about to announce his biggest
the
rap
biggest.
Artist. Of
rap
all
artist.
Time!
From
so this
Brandon
is a
K's
huge
perspective.
Deal. Brandon okay. K's gonna kick some butt. Let us know. Here we go.
Okay. So, my obvious answer is Eminem. But
Eminem.
You have to give credit to Dr. Dre and his albums and his influence to N.W.A. and all that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
So, I was gonna bring up 99, Chronic 2001.
Wow.
Oh,
okay.
Exhibit, Snoop Dogg, Eminem.
Okay. Can't go wrong.
Yep.
And it came out in 1999.
That's right.
Can't go wrong with it.
That's right. And that's what I was listening to back then.
Whoa. Oh, see, this brings it back
Me
to
too.
The 99 question.
Yep.
So Brandon K. brought it back to the 99 question as well as answering this new
right.
question.
That's right.
Which is a pretty awesome thing to do.
And I brought Dr. Dre in there with all the greatest rappers on Chronic 2001.
Yeah.
And don't forget about Tupac.
Tupac.
He was not on Chronic 2001, but he was
he
another
been.
Great artist.
He did California
What about
Love.
The B.I.G.? You forgot the B.I.G.
He was. Well, you know, I'm West Coast, right?
You're West Coast.
West Coast
West all
Coast. Day.
I'm on the West Coast. But
I mean,
I
talent is talent.
Throw
One
up your finger
rappers.
And let it linger longer than the rumor I was sticking into Christina.
Yep.
And Dr. Dre says.
One of my favorite rappers was Mace.
Okay, so he's from the East Coast as well.
That was
he's
Mo from, Money. Mo Money. Mo Problems.
Yeah.
Mace, Puffy, and Notorious B.I.G.
Boom. Okay.
He's from Biggie Small Squad. Yeah.
What was their hit? What was their hit? I forgot.
Mo Money, Mo Problems.
He just said it. Yeah, that was the big one. Mo Money, Mo Problems. That was the big one. And plus, they had many other hits besides that. But Brandon K is right. And very good.
1999. What a year.
What?
Rap for hip hop.
Year for hip hop and rap and.
Rap scene, entertainment. The entertainment industry, pretty much, period, in 1999 was great.
And then Weird Al, back in 96, did the Amish Paradise, which was Coolio. So Weird Al,
did you like Coolio?
He brought a little bit of hip hop back to. He brought a more hip hop to the mainstream a little bit. With that Coolio rapping.
Oh, yeah.
Coolio. By the way, West Your Soul Coolio. He just died recently. So rest
Coolio!
Your
soul, Coolio!
Goodbye, Coolio. But and, we're talking about Weird Al Yankovic and Amish Paradise.
And unfortunately, yes, when Coolio died, we all reflected on his career.
And we reflected on Amish Kenan Paradise.
Kenan and Kel theme song. Anybody?
Oh, yeah. I remember Kenan how it goes. Kenan and Kel. We're Kenan and Kel.
That is freaking Good Burger. That is right before Good Burger.
Yeah.
Right, and, like a couple years before the Good. Welcome to Good Burger.
I went and listened to a couple Coolio songs. Like he had one like Fantastic Voyage.
Oh, yeah.
He sampled Fantastic Voyage.
The Lakeside. Okay. Lakeside Band, which is a 70s group. Mm-hmm. He.
All right. Brandon K, we are glad to have you on this show.
Yeah.
Do you listen to the Byrds? Do you know the Byrds?
What do they sing?
Turn, turn, turn.
Yes. To everything. Yeah,
sure. To everything.
Yeah. That's a good song.
Turn, turn.
Do you know Buffalo Springfield?
Buffalo Springfield.
What do they sing? There's something happening
in here.
Yeah. What there you go.
Isn't exactly.
So that
here.
Was one of Neil Young's first groups, actually.
And Stephen Stills.
And Stills. Young and Stills, man.
Did you guys Come hear on. About Crosby.
That's what I was getting to.
We were going to, but that's later. We're going to do a special.
Do you listen
on
to the Hollies?
What's their song?
They sing that song.
Bus stop, but hey, she's there. I say,
under the umbrella. Oh, they sing long, cool woman in a black dress.
No, but do you guys know the Zombies?
Heck yeah, we know the Zombies.
Of course.
It's the time of the
What's
season.
What's your name? Who's your daddy? Yeah,
when
of course.
Love runs dry.
The Animals.
Oh, yeah.
I gotta get out of this place.
Yeah, that's my favorite
if
Animal.
It's the last thing besides we ever do.
There is a house in New Orleans. But
yeah, there's
do
so
you
much,
listen to Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Nash?
I do.
You know, that's them.
Is it really?
Yeah, that's them.
So how about the song goes, we are stardust, we are golden. Oh, wow. You know that song?
Not as much, but I know a lot of Neil Young.
Yeah.
And less Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young. But I know that they all work together.
They all work together.
So, yes,
so what
Crosby
we're getting to is that Crosby
just passed away
2 days ago, or a few days ago. That this past week where we were saying, and
we just want to say
rest his soul because the Running Gunner
Crosby
show
segment
is coming out with the super duper Crosby
segment.
Yeah, we're gonna kick some butt about Crosby.
But all right, everybody, we're here with Brandon K.
We're gonna conclude
you
this.
Heard it. Weird Al, Eminem, Dr. Dre, West Coast baby.
Oh, and, baby, and the most underrated rapper of all time, Weird Al himself.
Weird Al himself, you're right.
White and Nerdy.
White and Nerdy. Try to get some White and Nerdy.
He's fast. He's fast.
He can rap.
He did a Lose Yourself Eminem parody.
Wow.
Yeah. I haven't heard that one.
Awesome. Yeah. It sounds amazing.
He can rap faster, more words, all brilliantly put together. No one would ever think of him as a rapper, but I do.
Yeah, that's correct. Because
Weird Al, the rapper.
White and Nerdy, and I am agreeing with BK because I heard that White and
better
Nerdy
than Cardi
stuff,
B.
And oh yeah, man, come on, you're going
better than Drake.
You cannot, yes, I indeed. So what we're saying is that Weird Al is better than Cardi B,
better than
and
Kanye.
Drake.
I honestly like him better than Kanye. I know that I'll get heat for that. I won't say that out loud, but in my personal opinion, I listen to Weird Al. I have not ever listened to Kanye.
Yeah,
so maybe I don't know. There's a lot of things I don't know. I'm Gunner. I'm not Albert Einstein.
Yeah.
All right, everybody. This has been another episode of the Runner Gunner Show. We had Brandon K.
But they do call me Runner Tesla.
Go ahead and check out the Instagram, Brandon K Show. It's on Instagram.
Yeah.
Can I say Instagram enough? Also, we love
TikTok. TikTok,
Brandon K Show.
And www.brandonkshow.com. Links to my link tree, which has all my links.
And YouTube. And
there you have it. Yep. You guys know all the links. Tune in. You know, tune in to Brandon K and tune in to the Runner Gunner Show every Monday mornings
every Monday morning.
Spotify. We will keep kicking butt. And yeah, we want to thank you, Brandon K, for showing up. Mr. BK, thank you, sir, for coming and hanging out with the Runner Gunner Show.
But I have a question for you.
All right.
I don't know if this will be another episode.
I am ready for this question.
I don't know if this will be another episode, but what is your advice? Simple advice, how to treat a woman.
Well, that is easy.
Get her?
Well, first of all, you grab her by the arm and you say, come here, baby. And then you grab her by the... No, wait, hold on.
Hey, hold on.
I mean, grab her by the arm.
No, first you say hi first, to her.
So you're a little rough.
If you're Donald Trump,
you're a little soft.
You grab her, but
you're a little.
Hold on. No, let's end the show.
All right, everybody.
Sorry,
we gotta go.
We'll give you the greatest advice ever. But that is the next episode.
That is another episode.
That is in season six. We're gonna tell you how the chicks will suck your.
Whoa! What's going on?
Face.
How you treat a lady? And will be revealed on the next episode of the Runner Gunner Show.
But yeah, we like to thank once again BK, awesome. Where everybody tune into his show. He's gonna be great, and we are gonna be great as well, kicking butt. And you know what's up. But now we've got to go, and we have got to get on and going because everybody's already done, and everybody's getting where they gotta go. Thank you for listening, and thank you for tuning in.
You guys are great.
Thanks,
Runner and Gunner. Brandy K. Fucking Stardust, let's go.
Remember the words?
Roughly.
Okay. You, who are on the road, must have a cold.
Monday morning crack. And welcome to the special edition of the Runner Gunner Show.
The Runner Gunner Show. We're going to have a special interview after this show.
David Crosby. So today we're talking about David Crosby. We got a special edition interview after the show. But right now we are talking about Mr. Crosby. He's gone. And let's give it up.
Crosby's gone.
Yeah, Crosby's gone.
He's gone.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
So long. But he did a lot of damn good things to the rock and roll industry. He was born in Los Angeles, California. I've never heard of such a place, but that's where he's from. And he freaking kicked
David Crosby
so much,
was from Los Angeles. Is that what you're telling us?
I've never heard of such a place.
In Los Angeles?
I've never heard of such a place, but that's where he's from. Same place that we're from. He is from where we are from is what we are saying.
Probably those hills. Ventura Hills or whatever they're called.
Ventura. Wherever he's from, it's LA. Either it doesn't matter. Los Angeles, doesn't matter what hills, doesn't matter what dips.
What? No, does it say
doesn't what, matter what anything. Part of Los Angeles? It doesn't matter. None of it matters. All that matters is that he's from Los Angeles, California. Born and raised. And so now.
Not Los Angeles, he's in the Philippines, right?
I'm not even going to look at no Wikipedia crap. I'm just going to tell from what I know. This guy was amazing. His vocals helped the folk 60s impact everything. You know, everything. Crosby, Stills, Nash, Young were the best group ever to kick.
What is folk music? Hold on, let's ask Siri. Okay, Google. What is folk music?
Folk music is Crosby only by himself. Thank you, Siri! And wait, ask her again.
Okay, Google.
She didn't understand.
What is folk music? Folk music is I am a bitch.
Well, she doesn't understand because she does not understand that Everything that comes from folk music came from what the Beatles did. And it's all reflecting on the Beatles. It's all reflecting on rock and roll. It's rock and roll, but with a little twist, with a little more of a story, more of a laid back, you know, attitude. And it's very peaceful. It's more about just being chill and just being kicking it with your folks, pretty much. That's what they're mean. That's why they call it folk music, because you just got to kick it with your folks, have some folk music, you know, tell some folk tales, and grab a fork and just eat what you got to eat. And hopefully they're
marijuana brownies. Marijuana brownies. And it also includes traditional folk and contemporary, which have evolved. Sometimes have been called world music. It has been defined in several ways. It's always music transmitted orally with composers who are great and unknown, using regular instruments and not really having a cultural identity, but being cultural. The music has changed throughout the years, and it's been associated with folklore from days of yore. And it's also a custom that it's a long period of time.
So what the folk is going on?
And it's always contrasted from commercial and classical.
What in the folk is going on with the new music? Why the folk can't they get back to that old folk that they used to know? And why did they switch up to this new industry? Those are questions that we will not ask in this episode. But in this episode, we want to ask, why is Crosby gone? Why is his soul resting? Because he lived out his life as a good man. He did all that he can as a good man. And he contributed to
Crosby is gone.
Everything that That's he what was we're saying. Trying to do. Yeah, is he Crosby, was kicking butt.
His old little Eminem-looking little head and his silly little Popeye mustache. They're gone.
Mm-hmm.
He's gone.
But he used to say
2023 started
how
out
proud he was
with Crosby leaving
to the be, earth. You know, he was always proud of everything he did, which I respect.
He's an alien.
I respect how proud he was, because he, even if you screw up, a lot of people aren't proud of their screw ups. This guy, Crosby, was proud of his screw ups. If he screwed up, he would say, hey, you know, America, I effed up, I screwed up. And I'm going to go back to rehab. I'm going to fix myself. And I'm going to come back. And he would always do that several times. Yeah, he did it several times. He didn't do it once or twice. Yeah, he did it several times. So what happened was that when he came back from the several-ith time, he was still cool. And everybody really loved him for the music that he created, for everything that he did in so many people's lives. He changed so many lives that he is now a legend in everybody's mind who knows music, who is deep inside of music. It doesn't matter what genre you are. If you know music, you know this guy, Crosby.
So I got some interesting tidbits right here. Turns out that Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young haven't put out like a tremendous amount of albums throughout the years.
Yeah, only a few.
We got the very first album, which is their biggest, famous, most famous one, is Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, self-titled, in 1969. They put another one out in 1970 called Deja Vu.
Yeah.
But then they didn't put out another original album until 1977.
Whoa!
And that was called CSN.
The Big Break.
And then they didn't put out another serious album after 1977 until 1982.
Whoa! Wait a minute. What's that, 1982? Self-titled album, though.
It's not. It's called Daylight Again.
Wow.
And then after that, they didn't put out another album until 1988. And then after that, they put one out every couple years after 1988. They put one out in 1990, 1994, and 1999.
So David Crosby was amazing. I mean, no matter what, he was a musician. He was an amazing person. And he was super dope. There's not a lot of people that can surpass him in, you know, in music. There's not a lot of people that can surpass him. How many people do you know that have went through more than four generations of music and still sold millions? Not too many. I mean, there's not many at all. David Crosby did it. That is right.
1977, this is Deja Vu, everybody.
Oh, yeah.
Here's another little tidbit.
Oh, man.
This is the big one. Where's Nash?
This is our house. This is the big one.
Where's Nash?
This is a huge song for Crosby.
Very good voice.
I don't think that's
Nash? That ain't Nash. Or is that Stills? That's Stills.
Yes. That's Stills.
That's Stills.
That's even Stills, but Crosby is playing. Crosby is doing the
orchestra. Where's Nash?
Still a great song. Doesn't matter. Our house is Crosby. Turn up, man. Let's give the audience what they want. There you guys go.
David Crosby,
man, rest your soul. You are the awesomest guy that has ever been in folklore history. Besides,
you are the most awesome guy to ever been in folklore history.
I mean, there is
true statement. I agree and stand by it.
There is awesomeness, and he is on the top. You know,
you exist in folklore like you took folklore, which is like ages and ages and ages, and you recreated some folklore that people still live by standard till this day.
They do.
Of course, the Beatles standard is have greatness and be awesome.
Well, there is no
David Crosby's standard wasn't quite higher than the David Crosby's standard was more like do as much
as you can
and drugs
as you can.
As you can.
And then live to talk about it.
And then keep on doing it until the day you go back home.
And he met his maker. And we rest his soul. You know, that guy was a good guy. And he
was ready. He was ready.
It was time.
He was ready for years. He was ready.
The time was being called. And it was time. It was time.
You know who's still doing things? Ringo.
Ringo!
David Crosby and Ringo were very, very, very good friends.
Good friends. Who chilled in the yard?
And if you don't believe me, go ahead and put it on your little clickers, as Runner and Gunner and I call it.
Yeah, and ringo it up. Go ahead and ring it. You know,
David Crosby
versus Ringo.
Ringo Starr, baby.
Yeah, but they were good
friends. They were very, very, very good friends.
David Crosby back in the day was the man, though. He was the master. He actually used to throw licks down before that the Beatles never knew. And then Beatles loved him so much that they agreed that he would be just as good as Ringo.
See that?
Our Paul.
See the Beatles interview?
Let's ring it. Put it on.
That's him.
Put it on. That's him right there.
You see?
Put it on, yeah. David Crosby hanging out with the Beatles. This is real.
Why haven't you yet?
We tried, actually, but it was a financial matter.
So this is the time that David Crosby hung out with the Beatles.
But internal politics. Hush, hush, dice.
No comment. Mr. Lennon, is it true you're planning to give up music for a career in the field of comparative religion?
No.
Comparative religion? Whoa!
I'm sure you've all heard of the many Beatle burnings and Beatle bonfires. And I was...
So yeah, everybody... Crosby was an amazing guy. So he had so much talent hidden beneath his soul that he had to just release it. throughout his lifetime. And everybody's proud who has heard his music. And if you know his music, this guy sings so great. He really does. He really does. And he's an amazing interpreter when it comes to trying to bring peace on earth. If I look to be alright. And kick butt. I feel like I lost an anchor in the ocean of my night. Crosby! And I don't want you to see Stella, this way.
We got our bag of tricks over here dispensing bales in honor of David Crosby, everybody. Crosby, Stills, Nash. Crosby, Stills, Nash and Young. The Boyds. The Boyds.
Little more cracks. Cheers, everybody. So, yeah. Yeah, we're going to sip, but we're going to sip in honor of David Crosby. David Crosby. All right. So, the real deal is Crosby, Stills, Nash and Young were the best group ever that David Crosby was involved in.
And they only put out one album.
Let's hear one of the classics from Crosby, Stills, and Nash. And we know that these guys did evolve and they did change the whole world. And they made an impact on the 60s, 70s, and great 80s. All they did was do things great. Rest in peace. David Crosby. It's getting to
the point. David Crosby. Runner and gunner. We accept you, David Crosby.
We accept you. Sometimes it hurts so badly I must cry out loud. Yeah, I did. I am lonely. So
that. Oh, Runner, how about you tell us about that one time you saw
Crosby,
Stills, Nash, Young live?
I remember seeing.
Was Young there? Young was not
there. Young was not there.
He wasn't.
But there. I did see Crosby, Stills, Nash
live.
Back in, I think it was 04, 05.
Yes.
So it was just a minute ago. That wasn't too long ago. But these guys were still old. And these guys were still kicking major butts. I mean, Crosby still had it. You know, Nash was over there dancing around, clapping his hands.
Tell us about it. Like, if you could video camera it, what would it look like? What would that
video camera
it
through my own eyes. I would say that David Crosby was very still.
Stills? Not Stills. David Crosby.
David Crosby was very... very non-animative, if you could say that. Like, he didn't really move around too much.
So he was like, but maybe he was feeding off of Stills and Nash.
Yeah, but he was amazing. He was carrying them.
Because
at the same time, he was carrying them. He was carrying them with his voice because they were three in one. The song you were playing, what's it called? Blue Eyes, or what's it called?
Yeah, it was like Pale Something.
Something Blue Eyes or something like that. That was the biggest hit.
Can you take that back? See what it's called?
Producers.
I won't stay for long.
No, it's not called that. It's called Sister Blue Eye or Judy Blue Eye.
Oh, you mean Crosby, Stills, Nash.
Yeah.
It's called...
Anyways, that song, that's the main one I remember because...
Judy Blue Eyes.
At a young age, Judy Blue Eyes was producers, my favorite song.
Is that correct? Judy Blue Eyes? Yes.
So at a young age, I knew that song.
Look it up on Spotify and also look up the Runner Runner
track. I studied that song. And so, we seen it. And back in, we're talking like 23 years ago now. We're talking 24 years ago, something like that.
You saw them in 2004 and they played Judy Blue Eyes.
And they're already old. They are already very old. Old men, because these guys grew up in the 60s doing this stuff. So, yeah, it was pretty amazing.
Now tell us the truth. How many chicks flashed?
Man, only like 5 or 6. But that doesn't matter.
David Crosby still getting chicks.
He was still flashing
60
titties.
Years old.
It's true. 60 years old, flashing titties and ass. It didn't matter. You know, that there's no limitations to that. But what happened was that, yeah, he was singing, they were singing, and I had told the guy, you know, one section above me, or below me, I mean, he had a little thing, which was called a thingamajig, and he was like blowing it out and in and out, and he was smoking something, and I was like, yo, pass it to me.
Are you trying to say that there was a guy hitting a bong at the David Crosby concert?
Oh, that's exactly what I'm saying.
How did he bring it in? So that guy,
I have no idea. This is the early days. This is before 9/11. So, where actually? This is 9/12. This is before 9/12, and we were...
The great crash of 9/12.
Yeah, so 9/12, and we were... And anyways... Pass the bong was a normal thing. Like, it wasn't like they're not gonna pat you down for a bong, especially if you're not brown. And there was a lot of not brown people there, and we enjoyed passing the peace pipe together.
And so you saw David Crosby, and you said, "There he is in front of my eyes."
Yeah,
David Crosby.
Yeah, I seen him.
And Nash was next to him from the Hollies, which you didn't know who he was from the Hollies at that time, did you?
I had no clue. Tell the truth. I had no clue that
Bust Stop was made by that man.
I didn't know that Steve Nash created Bust Stop.
You didn't know that guy right there created Bust Stop.
I didn't know what Bust Stop was.
In front of your eyes, you saw him.
I didn't know what Bust Stop was. The creator of... Yeah. I did not know that the greatest...
But you knew that Stills was part of... There's something happening here.
I knew who Stills was. I didn't know who Nash was, and I knew Crosby was the man.
Yeah.
Was the creator of the whole group.
Because his presence, right?
Oh, man.
Was it a shiny bald head?
It was a shiny mustache.
Oh, his mustache shiny, dope.
Light brown mustache before it turned white. Completely white.
You know how many girls he's macked on with that mustache?
You know how many, 100 million.
You know how many ladies David Crosby has?
200 man.
Macked on with that mustache.
So when I seen this song, it was the most amazing thing that I ever seen at that time, at that point in my life. Not besides seeing Wu-Tang, besides seeing hip-hop and all this good stuff. But when it came into the rock and roll world, this is before I seen Paul McCartney. So I seen them first. And then once I seen Paul McCartney, that changed my whole perspective on rock and roll.
Unfortunately, Crosby, Stills, Nash, and Young didn't perform ever with the Beatles or any of the members of the Beatles. In fact, they were kind of unspoken rivals, even though they largely helped each other when it came down to it because they benefited from one another.
That was another media thing. The media wants you to feed into the rivalry.
But there's no like popular recordings between them.
Yeah, there is no popular recordings, but the media also wants you to believe about the rivalry so they can sell more albums. Who would sell more albums without the rivalry or with the rivalry?
Exactly.
So that's what the media believes.
Oh, yeah. You're agreeing with me.
Yes, I'm agreeing.
Yeah.
They say that the rivalry... Anyways, back to the concert.
The rivalry between the Beatles and Hollies and the Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young, it didn't exist because secretly the Beatles were helping...
And all of them.
Yeah,
the
Beatles, all of them.
The Beatles wanted to get everybody at the same level as
they're
the Beatles,
their friends.
Actually. They did. They weren't assholes.
You know how many girls Paul McCartney's macked on in his life?
More than David Crosby's.
But he stopped. Paul stopped, and David Crosby continued. And Paul McCartney still macked on more.
And so David Crosby was an amazing guy, and I did see him. This wasn't a lie. I'm not making it up. I did see David Crosby back in 04, and he performed this song, Kick Butt, and guess what? So many girls were going to his dressing room that night. Yes, it's true. David Crosby is still getting girls at freaking 165. It doesn't matter how old he was getting girls, and it's true. And I mean, man, I seen it with my own two eyes.
What concert had more girls? Grateful Dead or Crosby, Stills?
Wow. Well, we're not going to talk about that in this show because I do not want to disrespect.
Yeah.
I don't want to disrespect
all you deadheads out there. You might have missed a crucial moment in the Deadhead regime. I did go to a Deadhead concert,
and I don't want to disrespect
Crosby. Yeah, Crosby, you're right. Yeah. Crosby.
Goodbye, Crosby.
You were almost at the Deadhead level because of your time and age.
Yeah.
But let me tell you one other thing about David Crosby. Is he gave Mellisa Ethridge a baby.
It's like, baby.
He did it. She was.
Wait, that's not her.
She said she was a lesbian, but everyone knew. David Crosby got it whenever he wanted.
That's Mellisa Ethridge.
David Crosby got it whenever he wanted.
Yeah, well, she's a more. I mean, she gets her dick on. I mean, she had a son. She's a terrible person.
She had a son.
I mean, she's a great woman, but.
She did.
Crosby was a genius.
But Crosby, not
he was a genius.
Lesbians. That's kind of how his thing was.
That's
though.
His style. He can get with whoever he wants. And if you're.
Hippies, definitely. That was his thing. Hippies.
If you're hot that long.
1969, the year of love, the season of the season of Dove Soap.
Yeah!
David Crosby was the head of it. He was the one who inspired all that free love get-together Woodstock. He was at Woodstock. Him, Graham, Nash, and Stills were at Woodstock. Not young, but they were at Woodstock. David Crosby macked with so many girls. He took so many drugs in his life.
How many?
We're talking like peyote, psychedelics, LSD. He's got with so many girls. He was at Woodstock with Hendrix. And I'm telling you that David Crosby is just like a guy who's all about the ladies. Like, he don't even like drugs as much as he likes ladies.
Right on.
And that's all David Crosby ever get. And that's all that he got.
So God rest his soul. Yeah. David Crosby is the man. We love him. And this is the tribute to David Crosby today. The Run I Gotta Show. How can you catch the sparrow?
David Crosby, everybody.
David Crosby, everybody. So you guys better go, you know. Before you get up in the morning, just think about how you could David Crosby yourself. A new thing gotta be. How can you be David Crosby? See, but this is Steven Steele and David Crosby in the background. Yeah, David Crosby is shit. Excuse my language.
David Crosby is great. I hated him at first, remember? When you first met me?
You didn't like him.
I mean, yeah. When you first met me, when we first did the show, I mean, not when you first met me.
Way back.
I remember when he was a baby.
Yeah, for sure. I knew Ben since he was a baby.
I knew David Crosby since he was a baby.
Me too.
On video.
Me too. But now he's a hoo-ah.
Now he's a ghost. We're listening to ghosts.
It's just amazing. It's just amazing how you could progress so much from being a man to a man. Right on, Crosby. And if you listen closely, to hear Crosby on the floor. All right, everybody, we got to go, and we got to conclude this super-duper show about David Crosby.
But we are going to have a moment of silence for David Crosby.
Okay, yeah, before
because he died. He was 81, everybody. He made it. Like, he far passed the line of when he should have died because I'm telling you, he slept with every lady in the 60s. He did every drug there was available in the 60s until the 90s, and he was still doing drugs.
For sure.
And then he had diabetes, he had heart problems, he ate steaks.
Yeah.
You know, this guy, like, loved cookies and milk and life. You know, he just lived life to
the absolute fullest. Just live it. And especially if you live in America, live life to the fullest, man. Do not hold back.
And he still lived till 81. Back,
guess what? You hold back, you're a whack. That's what we say in America. And anyways.
But if you live to your full potential, then you are crucial.
And great. So, One moment of silence for the great David Crosby. All right, David Crosby. Well, we'll rest your soul.
Rest your soul, David Crosby. All right, everybody.
Peace and love, you know. Peace and love and joy inside your soul. And
him and Ronnie are making music now together.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Indeed. With Dean Martin and Frank Sinatra, of course.
Frankie's up there. Hell yeah.
Because when you're smiling. The whole world smiles with David Crosby now that he's in heaven. Keep on smiling.
Come on, David.
Smiling, yeah, he's up there. And laughing.
Okay, so we're in conclusion. David
Crosby's upstairs and the sun comes shining through.
We love Mr. Crosby and we love... You know, we love the journey. You know, we're here, we're doing our own journey, and we understand the journey. That's why we love the journey.
We understand the journey.
And we're saying, you know, peace and love.
Runner and Gunner and I, we're not afraid of that journey. And we tell all Lennies, because Lennies are afraid of that journey. What am I going to do when I die?
No.
What are you going to do when you die? How is that even a thought?
Because it's an extended life. You know, this is the first life and then the extended life. So David Crosby is living his extended life that he deserves to live. And we just want to say, God rest your soul and goodbye.
Live it up. Live it up. That's all we want to say. Live it up.
All right,
everybody. We got to go.
Now.
But remember, we want you to have a great gun day.
And always have fun. Drive home safely. Love each other, live with each other, and do not ruin each other. Just make the best of your Mondays that you can.
This was a very special Crosby edition of the Runner and Gunner Show.
Crosby edition!
Rest in peace, my friend. I hated you at first. I want to fuck you in your mustache and shine your bald head in the ball of shino. But then I heard you talk. And then I was like, oh man, this guy is dope. He definitely is someone who knows what he wants and says what he does.
And he does what he says and he says what he does. And that is how Crosby rolls. Rest your soul, Crosby. We love you, man. And for everybody out there, listen to the Runner Gun Show every Monday morning on Spotify. And just know that we love you guys.
Postponements are collateral that may occur during or post segments of our entirety of the show. You are now or have been listening to. We would like to add any involvement with similar subjects in the show are completely coincidental and may or may not be facts. We'd also like to thank you, Lennox.